After losing 98% of her sight to an autoimmune disease in her 20s, Encinitas resident Amy Dixon refused to let that slow her down. And thanks to new technology, the national champion triathlete's now training for the Tokyo Paralympics. Julian Delgadio has more from this neighborhood all-star.
Fox 5 Neighborhood All-Stars, powered by your San Diego County Toyota dealers.
Amy Dixon is a world champion, a 7-time gold medalist, and legally blind.
I was fully sighted as a child. I didn't start losing my sight until I was 22. So I never imagined at 44 years old with a rare eye disease that I would be a blind athlete representing the United States in a completely different sport that I had never experienced.
The Encinitas resident lost 98% of her vision to an autoimmune disease in her 20s, refusing to let that slow her down.
I had gained 75 pounds from the chemotherapy and steroids that I was on to control my disease, and I was really depressed and wanted to get back to exercising in some capacity, but being newly blind, I didn't know how that worked.
Finally relearning how to swim, bike ride, and run at her local YMCA.
Someone through social media had said, "You're swimming, biking, and running. Have you ever thought about doing triathlon?" I said, "Well, that's crazy. I'm blind. How does that even work?" And they said, "Oh, you do it with a partner, actually, and you race tethered at your waist while you swim and you run. And then when you're biking, you race on a tandem bike." And I thought, "Well, that sounds like fun. I'll try it." So 7 years ago, I did my first triathlon, and the rest is history.
And thanks to Iris Vision.
There we go. So when you open them up, it actually has a scene of the ocean and some beautiful Adirondack chairs.
The triathlete has set herself up for the 2021 Olympics.
A lot of the athletes that I work with are in IT, they work in office jobs, and they're in danger of losing their job because they're losing their sight. And something like this enables them to work for many, many years without having to go on government assistance. So I think it's just a life-changing technology.
And she's hoping that others discover this new technology that changed her life.
Knowing that the technology is out there to support us and help us achieve these goals and be regular contributing members of society, I'm super inspired and excited and a lot less of, I am going to lose the rest of my vision eventually. And so it's a lot less of a frightening experience knowing that I have the support of technology.
All while reminding us that you don't need to have sight to have vision.
This technology enables me to feel like I'm a part of the conversation, like I'm a part of a regular everyday life and less different. I can have my friends over for a movie. I can help cook and prepare food without worrying about cutting my hand. I don't have to slow myself down with things like this. I can go at full speed, and as a triathlete, that's definitely empowering.
Julian Delgadio, Fox 5 Sports.
Good to see her going full speed ahead. You may have seen her arm in a sling. Julian also said that the disease that Amy has causes inflammation, and she dislocated her elbow in her sleep. That's why she wore the sling. But she continues to train and move forward.